Very good morning, students. So today we are going to perform our fifth experiment. It is experiment number 5. Okay. So what is this experiment? This experiment is for the verification of superposition theorem. Okay. So our aim is verification of superposition theorem. Okay. So, student, this superposition theorem is valid for bilateral networks, a linear network, okay, which are containing more than two sources. Okay. So, the statement of the superposition theorem is that if a number of voltage or current source are acting simultaneously in a bilateral network, in a linear network, then the resultant current in any branch is the algebraic sum of the current that would be provided in that branch when each source act alone, replacing all other independent sources by their internal resistance or impedance. So while we will prove the superposition theorem, we will take one source acting alone only, okay, and we will replace the other sources by their internal impedance. Suppose I am going to show you the superposition theorem by a simple example here. I am going to create a simple circuit here. Okay, suppose this one is your RL, this is your current source, and this is the voltage source here. Okay, and suppose IL, current is flowing through it. Now, in superposition theorem, what we do, we take a source acting alone at one time. Okay. And we will find out that what is the net current provided by that single source. Okay. And we will replace the other sources by their internal impedance. Suppose firstly I am going to take this voltage source. Okay. So when I am going to take this voltage source, at that time I will replace this current source by its internal impedance. So you know the internal impedance of the current source is infinite. So I am going to open this circuit. Okay, since the internal impedance is infinite, so I am going to open this circuit at this point. So at this time, the current here would not be IL, it would be somewhat like IL dash. Okay, here. It would be IL dash here. Okay, now at second time, I am going to consider this current source, and I will replace this voltage source by its internal impedance. Okay. So for second time, what I am going to do? I am going to redraw the current source here, and I am going to short this end. Why I am going to short this end? Because the internal impedance of the voltage source is zero. That's why I am going to short this end. Okay. And at this time, the current which is provided by this current source is IL double dash. Okay. So we could write here IL double dash. Okay. So now we have considered one source at a time, and we have find out that what are the current provided by those sources while they are acting alone. Now what happens if both of these sources were acting? Then at that time we have considered that the current would be IL. So that means, according to superposition theorem, this IL dash plus this IL double dash should be equal to IL. This is what the superposition theorem actually states. We have considered this IL dash current when only we were considering this voltage source, and this current source was replaced by its internal impedance, and this IL double dash was considered when this current source was working and this voltage source was replaced by its internal impedance. And both of these current should be equal to this IL when both of these sources are acting. This is what superposition theorem states. Okay, so now we will move on to the experiment part and I will show you that how to prove this thing practically. Okay, so now I am going to brush this out. So for proving this superposition theorem, we do need the equipments. So I am going to write here equipment required. Okay, so firstly I am going to need a ammeter. Okay, so since we have multimeter, so I am going to write here multimeter. Okay, acting as ammeter. So first thing is this one, second one is our DC power source. In this case we will be using two different DC voltages. Okay, so for that thing we need DC power source. Okay, so we would need resistors also. Okay, so here we are going to use three different resistors. Okay, the resistors would be 470 ohm, 1 kilo ohm and 100 ohm. Okay, these resistors we will be using. And of course we will need connecting wires. We will need our breadboard to draw the connection. Okay, so these are those components which we need for our experiment. Now I am going to draw here a circuit. So I am going to take a DC voltage source here. Afterwards, I am going to connect them. First ammeter A1 here. First resistance here. Then again, second ammeter, second resistance. I am going to take another DC source here. I am going to take third ammeter here. So this one would be my R1, this one would be R2 and this one would be R3. Okay, this one would be voltage 1, this one would be voltage 2. Suppose the voltage 1 here is 10 volt and voltage 2 here is 5 volt. Okay, and now I am going to write the value of the resistance here. Suppose R1 is 470 ohm, this R2 is 100 ohm and this R3 is 1 kilo ohm. Okay, so here is the circuit for the superposition theorem. Now we will just assume the current here. Suppose the current here is I1, here it is I2 and here it is I3. Okay, so just check here, I have taken the current from this direction to this direction. That means the current is flowing in a clockwise direction here. Okay, this is what I am assuming. Okay, literally if you look analytically, then it would come true that current would be flowing in this clockwise manner only. Okay, so now according to superposition theorem, we are going to take one voltage source at a time. Okay, so what we are going to do in practical, we will take one voltage source at a time and we will replace the other voltage source by its internal impedance. Okay, suppose in the case one or in the circuit one, what I am going to do? I am going to replace this voltage source by its internal impedance. So how am I going to do it? I will just short the shunt. Okay, all this thing would be like this only, but I am going to short the shunt. Okay, so what I am going to do for the first case, I am just going to remove this one by a short circuit. Okay, in that time this I1 would be I1 dash, this I2 would be I2 dash, and this I3 would be I3 dash. Okay, these are the current which are due to this voltage V1 only. Okay, for this circuit one or case one. Okay, now I will take another case, that is of circuit two case. In circuit two case, what I will do? I will consider this V2 voltage only. And I will replace this V1 voltage by its internal impedance. Okay, so I am going to recreate here again a voltage source, that is my V2 of 5 volt, and I will replace this voltage source by its internal impedance. That means I am going to short the circuit. So at this time here the current I1 would be I1 double dash. Okay, just consider here I2 as I2 double dash and here I3 double dash. Okay, so I3 double dash would be flowing at this part, so it would be like this. I2 double dash would be like this and I1 double dash would be like this. Okay, in the second circuit part, okay, which would be like this. Okay, now we will check out that whether this I1 dash plus I1 double dash is equal to this I1 or not. Okay, theoretically we will find out that what is the value of I1 in the original circuit, and we will check the practically that whether the practical values are equivalent or equal to this I1 or not. Similarly, I would also check that whether this I2 dash plus I2 double dash would be equal to I2 or not, and this I3 dash plus I3 double dash would be equal to I3 or not. Okay, so these things we are going to check practically. Okay, so firstly I am just going to erase this double dash portion here. Okay, and I am going to recreate whole of the circuit to find out that what is the value of the I1, I2 and I3. Okay, if you will use KCL here, Ohm's law here, you could find out that what are the values. Okay, so I have found out the theoretical values of this I1, I2 and I3 while considering both of this voltage source. This one was 10 volt, okay, V1, and this V2 which is 5 volt. So the theoretical value of this I1, theoretical value is 0.010 ampere. Okay, this one is a theoretical value of I1, and the I2 value is around 0.004 ampere. Okay, and the value of I3 here is 0.005 ampere. Okay, so these are the theoretical values which I have found out, and now we will find out this I1 dash, I2 dash, I3 dash, I1 double dash, I2 double dash and I3 double dash practically. So now we will move on to our breadboard part, to our circuit part. So these are the devices. Now a DC power source, three ammeters are there. This one is A1 ammeter, the second one is A2, and the third one is A3. From the first one I am going to measure the I1 dash and I1 double dash. From the second one I am going to measure I2 dash, I2 double dash, and from the third one I am going to measure I3 dash and I3 double dash. Okay, this is the DC power source to provide the DC voltage, and these are the components. Just look here, there are three resistors, connecting wires, and the breadboard. So we'll use all these components to perform our experiment. So we'll now move on to our circuit, and I am going to now draw the circuit. So now I am going to connect the R1 resistance, that is of 470 ohm. So firstly I am going to bend the end of this R1 resistance, and now I am going to insert this resistance here in the breadboard. So just see, I have inserted the R1 resistance here. Okay, I am going to connect a ammeter, that is A1. So this one is the negative part of this A1 ammeter, and I am going to insert the positive end here. Okay, so this one is R1 resistance and this one is the A1 ammeter. Okay, so now I am going to connect my A2 ammeter here. The positive end of A2 I am going to short with the R1 resistance here. Just see here, this red wire is the positive end of the A2 ammeter, and now I am going to insert the black end of this A2 ammeter somewhat here. This one is the negative end of the second ammeter. So just check here, this one red wire is the positive end of the A2 ammeter, and the black wire is the negative end of this A2 ammeter. Now I am going to insert the third resistance in series with this A2 ammeter. Just see here, this is the second resistance. I have banded its end, and now I am going to insert it properly in the breadboard. I have inserted the R2 resistance also. So remember students, this one is for the circuit 1. Okay, in the circuit 1 I am going to use only one voltage source, that is V1, okay, which I would connect before this R1 resistance. Okay, so now at this positive end junction of the A2 I am going to connect my A3 here, and then in series of A3 I am going to connect another resistance. So just see here, I have shorted the positive end of this A3 ammeter here. Okay, and now this negative end of the third ammeter I am going to insert somewhat here. Just see here, so these all are the part of circuit 1. Okay, I am going to use only one voltage source, V1, and now this is the third resistance, and I am going to make it in series of this third ammeter. So I am going to insert it in the ends such that it would be in series with third ammeter and with the R2 resistance. So just check here, I have connected this R3 resistance such that the negative end of this A3 ammeter is in series with this R3 resistance, and this R3 resistance is in parallel with this R2 resistance. Okay, Now I am going to join this positive end of the power supply here at the positive end of first ammeter. Okay, so just look at here, I have inserted the positive end of this first ammeter. So just look at here, I have connected the positive end of this ammeter with the positive end of the DC power source here, and the negative of this DC power source, this black wire, I am going to put it in short with my resistor R2 and R3 last end. Okay, just look at here. Okay, so now my circuit is completed and I am going to review my circuit again, and I will tell you again that how is this connection made. So at this portion, starting from this portion, the leftmost part, I have connected the ammeter 1. Okay, this one is the positive end and this one is the negative end. Now the negative end of ammeter 1 is connected with R1 resistance. This, after this R1 resistance, I have connected ammeter 2. Okay, just check here. Ammeter 2 red wire is in short with the R1 resistance, and the negative wire is it in short with the R2 resistance. Okay, and at the positive end of this ammeter 2, I have connected the positive end of this ammeter 3, and the ammeter 3 black wire or the negative wire of this ammeter 3 is here, and it is in short with this R3 resistance. This R3 resistance is 1 kilo ohm, and I have connected the R3 resistance such that it is in series with this ammeter 3, and its other end is with this R2 resistance. In the circuit 1, I am going to use here only one power source, that is of 10 volt V1. So I have connected here the V1 voltage positive end, and the negative end of the V1 voltage is connected here at this end. Okay, so that this circuit would work properly. Now I am going to switch on my ammeters and the DC power source. So now I am going to switch on the ammeters and the DC power source, the ammeter 1, ammeter 2 and ammeter 3. So I have switched on the ammeters, and now I am going to switch on the DC power source, and we will increase the voltage of DC power source. Okay, just look at the readings of the ammeter and our DC power source. I will increase it up to 10 volt. Okay, so this is 10.1, so I am going to decrease it somewhat. Okay, so now just look here, the readings, the DC power source is currently giving 10 volt, and ammeter 1 is showing 17.97 milliampere current. Ammeter 2, it's showing 16.305, and ammeter 3 is showing 1.67 milliampere. So these are the readings which are shown when I am using the circuit 1. Okay, in the circuit 1, when I am giving only 10 volt, these are the readings. This first one is the I1 dash, the second one is I2 dash, and the third one is I3 dash. Okay, so I am going to write down these readings. So here in this paper, I am going to write down, here I am going to write down I1 dash, I2 dash and I3 dash. The reading of I1 dash is 17.97 मिली एम्पियर, आई टू डैश इज 16.30 मिली एम्पियर एंड आई थ्री डैश इज 1.66 मिली एम्पियर. सो जस्ट लुक हियर, दीज आर द रीडिंग्स ऑफ सर्किट वन. ओके, नाउ वी विल मूव ऑन टू सर्किट टू एंड वी विल चेक द रीडिंग्स ऑफ आई वन डबल डैश, आई टू डबल डैश एंड आई थ्री डबल डैश. सो नाउ वी मूव ऑन टू द सर्किट टू. सो नाउ लुक ऑन द सर्किट अगेन. In this circuit, now I am going to do some changes here so that I could use it as my circuit 2. Okay, so now for doing that thing, firstly I am going to remove my power source here, the negative end and the positive end of the power source I have removed. Now just look here, in the circuit 2 part I am going to provide the power at R2 end. Okay, so I am going to remove this R3 resistance also here. Okay, so now I am going to connect this R3 resistance in series with this A3 ammeter, but now from this side, this left side, okay, where A1 ammeter is present. Okay, so for that thing, firstly I am going to remove this A3 ammeter here and I am going to simply insert the R3 resistance here. So I have connected here the R3 resistance and now I am going to put back again this A3 ammeter positive end here at the junction of A2 ammeter positive end, and the negative end of this ammeter is with this end of the R3 resistance. Okay, now my R3 resistance, this end, okay, it would be shorted with the negative power source and it would also be shorted with my A1 ammeter. Okay, so I am going to use here a connecting wire, a small connecting wire, this, and I am going to short this resistance, this end, R3 resistance, this end with the A1 ammeter. So just look here, I have connected this connecting wire such that this R3 resistance left end would be shorted with the positive end of this A1 ammeter. Okay, just look here, the R3 resistance it shorted with the A1 ammeter, and this end also would be shorted with the negative power end of power supply. I am going to connect the negative end of this power supply here at this end, okay, and the positive end of the power supply I am going to connect it at the R2 end. Just see here, at the R2 end I have connected the positive part of this power supply. Now I am going to review the circuit again and I am going to tell you that which parts are connected where. Okay, so starting from the right side, this time this one is the positive end of the power supply V2, okay, for circuit 2 having 5 volt. I have connected it in series with R2 resistance 100 ohm, and afterwards I have connected A2 in series with this R2, and this one is connected in series with the R1, okay, and this R1 is connected in series with this A1. Now this A1 ammeter is connected in series with the R3 resistance, okay, and this R3 resistance is connected in series with the junction of this A2 ammeter positive end. Just look here, the positive end of this A3 ammeter is connected with the positive end of this A2 ammeter, and the negative end here of this A3 ammeter is connected in with series with the R3 resistance. And here I have provided the negative end of the power supply or of our DC power source, and here I have provided the positive end of the DC power source. So this is the circuit for my case 2, that is circuit 2. Now I will provide the DC power source, I will switch on the ammeter, and I will show you the readings. So now I am going to show you the DC power source and ammeter readings. So I am going to switch on my ammeter, ammeter 1, ammeter 2 and ammeter 3. Okay. So now I am going to switch on my DC power source here, and I am going to increase the voltages here. So just look at the readings here. I am going to increase the voltage up to 5 volt. So now look at the readings here. So look at the readings of first ammeter here. The current here is -8.2 milliampere. The current in E2 is -12.1 milliampere, and in the third one is 3.94 milliampere. Now this thing shows that in first ammeter and the second one ammeter, the current are negative. Just see here, a minus sign is present there. This means that the current is flowing in the reverse direction. Okay, for the connection which I have made here, the current is in reverse direction for A1 ammeter and A2 ammeter. That's why the readings are negative here in first and second part. Okay, but in the third ammeter it is positive. So I am going to write down these readings in the note sheet again. The current of this first ammeter, that is I1′, is -8.21 milliampere. The I2′ is -12.15 milliampere, and the I3′ current is 3.94 milliampere. Okay, so just look at here the readings of circuit 2 which I have taken. Okay, I have note down here in the note sheet here. Now I am going to switch off the DC power source, and I will shut down the DC power source, my ammeters, and we will move on to the board part. And in the board I will show you whether the values which we have taken practically would match the theoretical ones or not. So students, just look at the datas which I have taken here. Now I am going to analyze these data with the theoretical ones, and I am going to check whether superposition theorem is applicable here or not. Okay, so I am going to just zoom out, and I am going to write down these data in observation table here. I am going to write down the observation table. Okay, so I am going to write down here circuit 1 data, circuit 1 here, circuit 2, and here is the sum or addition. Okay, so just write here circuit 1 here only. Okay, Okay, so the first data, that is my I1, here I could write here I1 is equal to 17.97. okay, so all these data are in milliampere. Okay, so I could write here milliampere, here also, and here also I am going to write here milliampere. So all data are in milliampere. Okay, so these are the circuit one data here, this I1 dash I2 dash is 16.30. okay, this I2 dash is 16.30 and the I3 dash is equal to 1.66 milliampere. okay, so these are the data of I1, I2 and I3 dashes. Okay, now we'll write the data of circuit 2. Here I1 double dash was -8.21 milliampere. okay, and here I2 double dash is -12.15 milliampere, and I3 double dash is equal to 3.94 milliampere. okay, now if you will sum here, okay, this I1 dash plus I1 double dash, their sum is equal to 9.76 milliampere. okay, this is the sum of I1 dash and I1 double dash. Now the sum of I2 dash and I2 double dash is 4.15 milliampere, and the sum of I3 dash and I3 double dash is 5.60 milliampere. So now just look at the readings. The practical data is nearly equivalent to the theoretical data. Now I have written here the practical data in milliampere. You could convert it in ampere, and you will find that the data of the practical value is nearly equal to that of the theoretical value. Okay, the data are nearly equivalent. Okay, these are not equals because of some error. Okay, and the major part, the major reason of the error is the tolerance of the resistance. All of the three resistance were having a gold band at their end, that means 5% tolerance were there. And remember, if my connection would lose, okay, or if my connection is loose, then also I would get a more fluctuated data here. But my readings were stable, that means that the connection was proper. So the reason of this deviation in the practical and the theoretical data is because of tolerance. Okay, so this means that my superposition theorem is applicable for the circuit. This is the final part of this theorem. Thank you for watching.